Hello, my name is Hank Feen, and I'm the Director of Center on Teaching and Learning in the College of Education at the University of Oregon.
Hi, I'm Gina Biancarosa, and I'm an Associate Professor and the Ann Swindells Chair in Education at the College of Education at the University of Oregon. I'm also a Research Associate at the Center on Teaching and Learning, where we've been engaged in the research and development that has gone into DIBELS 8th edition. Research on DIBELS Next is a decade old at this point, and obviously the field has moved in the last decade. Practices in classrooms have changed, legislation has also changed the context in which those classrooms are operating, with new dyslexia legislation in a plurality of states across the U.S. So we felt it really was time for DIBELS to catch up to current practices. And that's what DIBELS 8th edition is designed to do. We are also, as part of this revision, addressing some long-standing critiques, not only of DIBELS, but of reading curriculum-based measures in general. And so really, those were the driving motivators when we decided to create a new version of DIBELS. What's so special about DIBELS 8th edition? Well, first of all, we've expanded DIBELS to cover grades from kindergarten all the way through eighth grade. In addition, we have consistently heard from our customers that you would like more consistency in the subtests that are offered within a grade level. And so we've implemented that as well.
We've also used advanced statistical procedures to increase the precision of identification of students at risk, which have resulted in much stronger concurrent and predictive validity and diagnostic accuracy of the measure. While we've applied the most rigorous research, we also are very confident of the continued ease of use and efficiency of using these measures. So we've relied on good science and transparency, but we haven't reduced the ease of use and the user experience to give the user, the tester, the best experience possible as they're testing their students.
In addition, we have introduced new subtests in grades K to 3. Specifically, we have introduced a word reading fluency measure, and we've also extended nonsense word fluency through the end of grade 3 in order to really extend the safety net that we have in order to capture students who are having difficulty with reading at the word level. And finally, we have gone to fairly extreme lengths in order to minimize form effects that have been a critique in the research field around curriculum-based measures.
You'll find some subtle and some very obvious improvements of the new DIBELS 8th edition measure. One of the most thrilling advances is that instead of 3 oral reading fluency passages, schools and districts will be able to deliver one passage based on equating work to reduce measurement error and to increase the confidence teachers can employ when they monitor progress for students. For one student, the difference between 3 minutes and 1 minute of measurement may not be a lot, but if you're testing 1,000 students or 5,000 students in the district, this is a significant amount of time savings.
One of the most exciting new features is the fact that our oral reading fluency and maze passages have been written by published authors. The passages, as a result, are far more engaging for students to read and understand, as well as for teachers and test administrators to listen to being read.
We've also used key measurement approaches for screening for dyslexia, attending to the research base and the core aspects of phonological processing has guided our revisions and the addition of new measures. At the same time, we've carefully simplified the administration of measures through discontinuation rules and other approaches to make sure students are able to give their best performance and teachers and district leaders can be confident that the information that they're deriving from the tests are valid.